God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth should change, though the mountains shake in the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam, though the mountains tremble with its tumult. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. God is in the midst of the city. It shall not be moved. God will help it when the morning dawns. The nations are in an uproar, the kingdoms totter. He utters his voice, the earth melts. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Come behold the works of the Lord. See what desolations he has brought on the earth. He makes war cease to the end of the earth. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear. He burns the shields with fire. Be still and know that I am God. I am exalted among the nations. I am exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. The next day, John saw Jesus coming toward him and said, "Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. This is he of whom I said, 'After me comes a man who is preferred before me, for he was before me. I did not know him, but that he should be revealed to Israel. Therefore, I came baptizing with water.' And John bore witness, saying, 'I saw the Spirit descending from heaven like a dove, and he remained upon him. I did not know him, but he who sent me to baptize with water said to me, "Upon whom you see the Spirit descending and remaining on him, this is he who baptizes with the Holy Spirit. And I have seen and testified that this is the Son of God." Again the next day John stood with two of his disciples, and looking at Jesus as he walked, he said, "Behold the Lamb of God."
Of love, they crucified, they left and scorned him as he died. The humble king they named a
Let us pray for relief from this coronavirus. We pray for healing for those who are infected. We pray for all who already have lost loved ones to the illness and to those who will yet suffer loss. We pray for doctors, nurses, and aides providing medical care, for insight in their caring and for their health and well-being. We pray for wisdom for the medical and scientific experts who are desperately seeking ways to control the spread of the virus. We pray for public officials who must make hard decisions about the quarantining of those who may have been exposed to the virus. And we pray for all those for whom those decisions feel like unjust imprisonment. We lift up the church around the world. We pray for God to keep us alert to the threats posed by such a worldwide crisis, remembering the millions of God's children who live in places where the availability of medical care is meager or non-existent. May God open our hearts, our financial resources, and our political will so that the vision of a better future can become a reality for all of God's children. In the providence of the God who created us, in the passion of our Savior Jesus Christ who redeems us, and in the power of the Holy Spirit through whom God's will is done, and the blessing of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, be with us and remain with us, today and forevermore. Amen.